In this illustration, we'll discuss about mixing of ice, water and steam. We are given that in a mixture, 35 gram ice and 35 gram water is in equilibrium. And to this mixture, 4 gram steam at 100 degree centigrade is passed. And the whole mixture is in a copper calorimeter of mass 50 gram. We are required to find the final temperature and composition of mixture. And we are also provided with the specific heat of water, copper and the latent heat of fusion as well as latent heat of vaporization. Here in solution, we can start with the mixture. We are given that the mixture in the given problem is equals to 1 as 50 gram copper we are having at 0 degree centigrade. Plus, we are also given as 35 gram ice at 0 degree centigrade and 35 gram water at 0 degree centigrade and 4 gram steam at 100 degrees added to it. So, this 4 gram steam at 100 degree centigrade. Now, these three substances are at 0 degree and the steam is at 100 degree centigrade. If we transform it to 0 degree centigrade, then the first steam will condense in water and releases some heat. And water at 100 degree after condensation will drop to 0 degree and will further release some heat. So, this will transform to 4 gram water at 0 degree centigrade plus 1 heat it will release, 4 into 10 to power minus 3 multiplied by 2.25 into 10 to power 6 joule of heat, the latent heat of vaporization, and water will fall from 100 degree to 0 degree centigrade, that will further release a heat. 4 into 10 to power minus 3 multiplied by its specific heat is 4200 multiplied by the temperature is 100. So, this is the amount of heat which water will release. So, here we can write now mixture is equals to 50 gram copper at 0 degree centigrade plus 35 gram ice at 0 degree centigrade plus, here it is written as 39 gram water also at 0 degree centigrade plus the total amount of heat. If we add up this total heat, it gives us 10.68 multiplied by 10 to power 3 joule of heat. Now, this much amount of heat when supplied to ice, this will further melt. And if whole ice will melt, then we can say this remaining heat after melting the whole ice will raise the temperature of system. But here we first calculate the amount of ice melted is, this total amount of ice melted we can write as Q divided by latent heat of fusion. The heat available is 10.68 into 10 to power 3 divided by the latent heat of fusion we are given as 3.36 into 10 to power 5. If we simplify it, this gives us 31.78 multiplied by 10 to power minus 3 kilogram, or this 31.78 grams. That means whole ice will not melt. If the amount will come out to be more than 35 gram, then we'll melt the whole ice and keep the remaining available heat to raise the temperature of the system. But in this case, this much amount of ice will melt and remaining water will still be there. So, we can write as ice-water mixture is there after absorption of whole heat, then we can write the equilibrium temperature of mixture is 0 degree centigrade, which is one result of the problem. And the composition of mixture we can write, out of 35 gram ice, 31.78 gram is melted. So here we can write 35 minus 31.78 will be 3.22 gram of ice is there in the mixture, plus this 39 gram water plus 31.78 will be 70.78 gram water. This is the final composition of mixture available at 0 degree centigrade, and that is another result of this problem.